An anonymous viewer asked, or suggested, a source in the Talmud where it says that prophecy has finished and will not return to Israel, or that it has transformed into the cries of fools, or into the speaking of babes, that it does no longer exist or is no longer understood. Indeed, it appears to me that prophecy does exist. I see it time and time again with people, so many remarkable people who have a great sense of mission and who devote their times to incredible ideas which have transformed the world. Great doctors and scientists and physicists and people who work together in groups and are determined and push the envelope and who are prepared to pay a personal price for their feelings, and that combined with brilliance, and that combined with innovation, and that combined with a lot of luck and possibly the divine intervention, then something magical happens. And I think that that has happened in Israel recently. I think that incredible achievements of our leaders from Herzl, who envisaged the state and proceeded to build it, and to Ben Gurion, the founder of the state, and to other great thinkers and humanists. I think that to inventors of cures for cancer, or for blindness, or for pain, and the great leaps and bounds that we're making in technology. I see prophecy happening everywhere. I see prophecy being taught to babes. I see prophecy in the hands of 3-year-olds. Our youth are so informed today, and the abilities for us to do things. Prophecy will be a day-to-day event. People will be prophesying daily, a few times. This great inspiration, the great connection with the active intelligence, as Maimonides, the great rationalist Jewish philosopher, said that the prophecy has different stages in it, but in its most active stage is the combination of the active intelligence with the imagination, and the guided imagination, where one allows for the mind to go into all sorts of different ways that only... How does one know where it goes? But to guide it with one's methodologies, with one's nose, with one's bodies of knowledge, and to allow and to share and to really respect other people and their experiences, and the ability to be able to share and to empathize with other people. Because the source of the prophet of inspiration is to hear things from other people and other places, and have deep feeling, and to be able to imagine the circumstances and apply it. And so that prophecy is alive and well, I feel, in the modern age in Israel, and I believe that it is an incredible source and resource for our future. My personal preference is the mixing of science, technology, and religious education, and the biblical texts, and the synthesis of these two primary sources, I think will bear its own fruit. People will be inspired and will understand the implications of the knowledge to their own times, and they will the spiritual may be upon them. I'm looking forward to a great time of inspiration in the region.